Hello friends, in the series on the income tax cases, today we will discuss a very important case on section 68. This case throws light about the provisions of section 68, that how the provisions of section 68 actually affects the assessee and how the addition can be made under section 68. In the present case, the question before the tribunal was that for section 68, whether there is any difference between the trade credit or the cash credit. The second issue was that if the assessing officer does not mention 68 or the provision under which he is going to make the addition, so whether in those cases the addition is justified or not. And the third issue was that when the assessing officer makes inquiry under section 133 subsection 6 and if it gets any negative report, then whether it is the duty of the assessing officers to confront this report with the assessee before taking any adverse view against the assessee. All these issues have been taken up by the Jaipur ITAT A bench in the case of Raj Auto Wheels Private Limited versus Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax, and this case has been reported in 111 ITR Tribunal at page number 199. The date of the judgment is 9th November 2022. In the present case, there was a small issue also. It is very important to discuss. In the present case, the assessee was claiming some prior period expenses which were related to the earlier years, but it was the submission of the assessee that liability to pay those expenses have arisen in the current year, has crystallized in the current year, and in the prior period case, prior period expenses, if the liability arises in the current year, then it can be booked and claimed in the current year, subject to the assessee proves beyond doubt that the liability of those expenses have crystallized in the current year. But in the present case, the assessee was not able to prove that, so the tribunal disallowed those expenses. This was the small issue. Now the main issue was that the assessee was a dealer of Maruti Suzuki. The assessee has received advances from 1500 customers. The assessing officer was sleeping throughout the year, but he awaked at the fag end, and in the last 3 months he made the inquiries in a haphazard manner and concluded the assessment in a high pitch assessment. During the assessment proceedings, the assessee submitted the ledger copy of 1400 customers, the sale bill and the ledger in which it was properly explaining that those advances have been adjusted either against the sales or they have been refunded, whether they have been adjusted or refunded in the current year or in the coming years. During the assessment proceedings, the learned assessing officer made inquiry from the registering authority under the Motor Vehicle Act regarding 5 customers, and the reply came from the registering authority that no vehicle has been sold to them. So the assessing officer, on the basis of this inquiry, made a negative view against the assessee and said that all these advances are not genuine and added them without mentioning even the provisions of the Income Tax Act, that under which section he is going to make the addition. Even the CIT appeal went against the assessee. When this matter came to the tribunal said that this is not a case of section 68 addition because it is a matter of trade creditor and not cash creditor. So in the present case, to prove the credit worthiness of the assessee is not desirable and not practical, meaning thereby that in broader sense the section 68 is not applicable. In the present case, the advances have been received from 1500 customers, and whatever the inquiry has been done, the result of that inquiry has not been confronted to the assessee, and this has been done at the back of the assessee. Since the assessee has given all the documents to prove the identity, credit worthiness and genuineness of the transaction, so the addition cannot be made. The tribunal said that the revenue at the same time is saying that these advances are not genuine, and at the same time The revenue is alleging that these advances have been adjusted in the coming years. So, this type of approach is contradictory in nature, and it clearly shows that the additions have been made in a high-handed manner. So, the tribunal deleted the additions by saying that in the case of Motor Vehicle Act, the vehicle is registered in the name of the customer after doing the insurance. So, in those cases, the identity of the customer cannot be doubted, and the addition under Section 68 or any other section cannot be made where the assessee has complied. The various responsibility of the assessee to prove the creditworthiness, genuineness and identity of the customers. The tribunal said that the assessee has to shift, or the assessee has to prove the only the initial burden by giving the various papers, and the assessee has not to prove to the hilt of the matter. And once the assessee gives the initial papers, the burden shifts on the assessing officer. So, by concluding, the tribunal deleted the addition. At the end of this video, once again, I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Raj Auto Wheels Private Limited versus Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax. And this case has been reported in 111 ITR Tribunal at page number 199. And the matter has been decided by Jaipur ITAT A Bench. And the date of the judgment is 9th November 2022. Thank you, friends.